unit of Alarcon. You saved lives. No matter what happens, remember that. Now then, let's do what we can for the wounded. Every minute counts. See to the wounded. If they live, help them. If not, move on. Fred lies motionless, having breathed his last. Clenched in his fist is a small charm, which you take for safekeeping. He's already called when I got to him. There's nothing I could do. Charm must have been important. Best take it to Conrad. Mefrid, where are you? This is... He's dead, isn't he? Mefrid was a warrior. Always thinking about others before himself. Once had an Imperial patrol chasing an eye on 20 Malms so that his wounded would have time to escape. Comrades loved him for it, of course. But that only made him worry more. He really sent his men in Quarry Mill away because he thought they were fighting for him, and not the cause. Aye, well he did. The life he was willing to risk was his own, you see. He's exactly the kind of man who should be leader. Kind of man who deserves to survive. Not an old fool who's all used up. No logic to it, Master Kemp. There never is. Who stands, who falls. In need of battle, he can but do our best. As he did. Creed will be sorely missed, aye. Because of his sacrifice, many now live who otherwise would not. They need us. Now more than ever. Aye, that they do. Forgive me. I had high hopes for him is all. Defeat was no near thing. It was total humiliation. We were powerless to withstand our enemy's assault. We cannot afford to dwell on our failure. As Alfino said, who survived, whom we must think of now. Ralgar's reach is no longer safe. Imperials may have withdrawn. They could return at any time to finish what they began. We dare not remain here. Those who are not fit to make the journey to Castor Morians will need to be taken by Chocobo carriage. Agreed? Good. She'll oversee preparations for the carriages. In the meantime, I would have you scour the infirmary for any supplies that might prove useful during the journey. Quest marker back here. Ah, in there. Something I would ask of you, lad. Join the resistance against my mother's wishes. She awaits me back in my hometown. Lucky to still be here after that last battle. I don't want to take her love for granted anymore. Please, deliver this bandana to Mother in Alagana on my behalf. Tell her that I said thank you. I want her to know I understand why she objected to me joining the fight against the Empire. Forgive me, but it is imperative that if I continue preparing medicines for the wounded, if you desire treatment, I must ask that you seek it elsewhere. Oh, I see. In that case, you are free to search the barber and take that which you require. We're not our people dying en route. It would assist you, but this process demands my undivided attention. Anything else to say after that little comment? No? Okay. Lieutenant Shade, Master Turpin said you might have something for me? Yes, some medicine. Oh, be praised. This should put the driver's hearts at ease. Tell the Vice Marshal we await his orders. You stole and the others are safely strapped in. Don't worry, I'll be by your side the entire time. Thank you, Kral. Walk alongside. Lend you protection in case the Garleans try anything. Injured too. Shouldn't you be in one of the carriages? Not so frail that I can't make the trip on my own. Besides, there's still work to be done here. See you at the wall when it's finished. As you wish. Let us sail forth at once. We shall move as quickly as our comrade's health allows. Castromorians. Hey, NPC, thanks for the raid. If my frames don't want to have a hemorrhage. I know. Thanks for the raid, LND. What were you up to tonight? We're in our Wind Waker era. I think the last time I checked in, you were having fun with some bird. Ah, first try at Ganon. Presume from that language there will be more attempts at Ganon. Saved a good many of my men. Cannot thank you enough for that. Fact remains, forces were decimated. This state will not be mounting an assault on Custom Velodyna or anywhere else. We need to be honest with ourselves about our prospects. First, we need to put our affairs here in order. Afterwards, I'll join you at Castor Morion's. Understood. I'll go and speak with General Alden. Okay. Welcome in, Raiders. I am Archon Shade. I play Cat Games right now. That is an all-quest playthrough of Final Fantasy XIV as a Mikote monk. Thanks for the follow, Delphi. And Brian, that's not how you say NPCs. I'll go and speak with General Alden. Make another temp. Controller makes a joint so my hands sore and had to stop. The third variation. Aristocats is a great movie. I decided when I was doing the cat theming, it fit. Pippin has already departed with the wounded, has he? Good. We've completed our reach, our search of the reach in the surrounding area. As far as I can. As we can tell, Zenus and his men returned straight towards the Specula Imperatoris after quitting this place. That seems he's lost interest in us. Which brings us to the most troubling question of all. Not how he found us, why he chose to spare our lives having done so. In war, you kill or capture your enemy. You don't leave him to fight another day. Only a fool would turn his back and walk away. Zenus is no fool. Yeah, I can't imagine that would be particularly enjoyable to play for long periods of time. Whatever his motive, this is neither the time nor the place to think on it. We'll leave a token for us to watch over the Reach. The rest will fall back to Castor Morion's. We can discuss our path toward there. I'll go, you rest your hands, and best of luck on the next attempt. Okay, so you're in Castor Morion's. I've got a quick little jump off to Alagana. Are we approaching? Oh, hello, what's this? Okay, what do you want me to do, Ragnfried? And I'm assuming this is to unlock an Aetherite current, yeah. Aether current. Fancy yourself as your village's savior, do you? If you truly mean what you say, I have a mind to introduce you to someone. His name's Sayer. Used to be one of the Korra's finest workers, he did. Keeps fighting the good fight to restore Alagana to its former glory. I do worry about the toll it must be taking on a man of his years. Have a chat with him if you're interested in helping. I gotta go tell this kid's mom that he's sorry. Looks like you're outside. Yeah, there's the mother. We met. Nope. This is my voice. Something happened to him. Nah, he's fine. Thanks heavens, he's still safe. I tried to dissuade him of joining the resistance, but he would not listen. We had a big fight, and he wound up sneaking out in the dead of night. It was a weight off my mind to learn that he does not resent me. The fact he's returned this bandana must mean he intends to continue fighting. If his resolve is truly that strong, then there is little chance of me convincing him to come home. I'll continue for a safe return. Oh, that unlocks something here. What do you want, Gerbert? Don't look like a garland. assuming I'm correct, could you help me deal with the little pest problem? For since the Empire outlawed the practice of all religions, I've been unable to pray at Hidden Tear. Instead, decided to create a spot in the southwest where I could mourn the dead in secret. Problem is, whenever I leave offerings of food for the deceased, those blasted robber rats gobble them up for themselves. That is why I've created this. One whiff of it, and those pests will be on their way. Now, make sure to be on your guard. Some of the more aggressive rats may attack you instead. Am I not a little bit high level for... Please, sir, help me with my rat problem. It's like level one adventuring stuff, people. Thank you for coming. I'm still waiting for a few more of the villagers to arrive. He's treating us to another one of his speeches, I see. How long do you plan to continue living in abject squalor, I ask you? It's high time we brought back the quarry that once made me proud to hail from Alagana. Some of you may be too young to remember. The quarry used to mean everything to this village. Bloody hells, when is this old codger gonna stop harping on about the good old days? Tell me you open your eyes, you daft bugger. Time's long since passed when we could sell the stone here for a decent amount of gil. It's about time you face the facts. There's no coin to be had sweating away your life in some bloody quarry. I'd be better served going out and hunting my own food. Just hear me out. If you give up on the quarry, then you'll be giving up on the village itself. Even the hardest rocks will break if you keep chiseling away at it. Life's the same. Grandfather, that's enough. I can tell you now that no one here would claim to be happy with their lot. There's nothing that can be done. You remonstrating with everyone is hardly going to do any good. Sweet love. Well, what do you bloody expect with that attitude? No one's gonna work to improve things when even my own granddaughter has next to no motivation. There's a reason you don't see much quarrying going on anymore. There's no demand for it. I just fine with the stones we gathered in the past, and those we salvaged from ruined buildings. Prosperity doesn't lie in wait for us at the quarry, only monsters. It's about time you realize that we're lucky to be alive, just be alive these days. Come on, Grandfather, let's go home. Come on, Grandma, let's get you back to the home. This girl understands nothing. Of course, everything's going to seem partless if you only sleepwalking through life. Who the hell's are you anyway? I ain't doing this for your amusement. Then why are you doing it? When did the sire you speak of? Dragon Street sent you my way. Anyone else hear that music? Why is that music playing? Crap. Archon, was it? See you, lad. We have to thank for saving Warcrata. I can tell you have more fire in your belly than this entire village. Perhaps you'll be able to see that I'm not as crazy as buggers think me. Considering the Hildebrand music just played while talking to you, I have my doubts. Archon owes everything to the quarry. Stones we extracted were solid and pleasing on the eye to boot. We even supplied the stone used to build the palace. Ah, those were the days. It was the Imperial invasion that changed everything. These bastards thought stone structures barbaric, favoring their cold, tasteless, metallic buildings instead. They say they look civilized. Don't make me laugh. Final blow to our own way of life was came when Garlemald began recruiting our youth for their own army. Lost just as many of the rebel cause. No one left to tend the quarry. Slowly fell into ruin and is now overrun with beasts. A few of us that remain have been left to get a living using any means we can. Swore on Rogger's very name, if we could just take back the sleeping stones, this whole village would brim with vitality again. Just need something that proves the beasts are gone from the quarry. Then the villagers would surely see fit to help me restore to its former glory. And This is a lot to ask of a complete stranger. It's not as if I'm spoiled for choice right now. Would you be able to get rid of the... Would you be able to rid the quarry of these damned monsters and bring me back two Auroralis Soulstones? I'll be forever in your debt. Don't mean to go all the way. Okay. I'm gonna be doing a bit of running around, I guess. Sun for the southwest. How does this work exactly? I'm trying to remember or figure out how I'm supposed to get over there. Does it involve going through this? Not that way. Oh, I think I remember. Yeah, it's like circling around like that. Getting very dark. Oh. Oh, I have to find stuff up here, that's right. That hit me? Okay. We got our Auroralith stones. Now I just need to get... I think I can jump off the top of the waterfall. Yep, Geronimo. Oh, That was a long way down. Nice to see your turn. Be nicer if you happen to have you in possession of certain stones. So demanding. Yes, this is exactly what I was after. Let's waste no time in showing the others. It's been far too long since the last ray of hope shone into the villagers' miserable lives.